with me, say.
Du melang bahaya tu du melang. Du melang bahaya tu. Lina la kaki doktor mukhmu cikah bana khosi. Ken nayo kiku pilu angkor kita kau cama isa tiroi. Meki du melang kore kita kau nak kau cama isa sente. Fa nalelo na re dirisana moh. Karena nak kue kahalu, nak war nice teri si, lekora kore rau chana kyo tabohato taki abona kore, kona lidi buidi le maluanyana, kya kupa kacue, kore fire 8:30, change berfedit, completely. So kora kore center nale less than an hour. Fa ka calculate sente because mo gare ga yone o rena le moruti ya no ke a go kopa gore di buite di buang renne ba khutshwane selo se se monate ke gore motho yo na le ditiro gantsi batho ga nke ba sokola go motlhalosa o dirisa fela le foko le one fela go se go ukwala gore go diragalang ya no ke a go kopa gore let's try by all means to be short and straight to the point. Let me take this opportunity, Hokopa Moruti Talang, to open with a prayer. Thank you, Moruti.
Shall we bow our heads and pray? Father, we thank you, we bless you, my God. The Bible says, when two or three are together in your name, Lord, there you are in the midst of them. We welcome you, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of comfort, the Spirit of love, to lead and to guide us during this funeral service. I pray, Lord, for the family. I pray, Lord, for Tabo's children. And everybody, my God, who have been affected by the passing away of Dr. Koho. Heavenly Father, we know that we cannot handle this send of service without you strengthening us. without you assuring us that you are God who is in control. We thank you, Lord, boldly. We come before your throne room, knowing that we shall obtain grace and mercy in the time of need. In the mighty name of Jesus, every speaker, I pray that you touch his or her lips so that at the end of the service, all of us, we should say, Ebenezer. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we have prayed, and everybody say, Amen.
Re a leboga moruti ka thapelo ke tla kopa ka gangwe fela gore re ye ko sefeleng ka tswetswe re na le DJ a ko re letsetse sefela fo ke a leboga. Ntate Dan Marokwane jaaka mooki, thank you. Morago ga gagwe go tla latela tsala e bong Tshipi Alexandra. Thank you, Ntate Marokwane.
Dumelang. Nakina Dan Marokwane. I've known Thabo for just under 20 years. I met him when he had just completed his graduate training as a young engineer. And I think in many ways, like for many other people, I just became an instrument of God in making him reach his true potential. He reached his true potential out of his own hard work, out of utilization of the gifts that God gave him. And for that, I remain forever grateful that the little part that we created for him, he could take and fully utilize. I met Thabo, as I said, as a colleague. He worked in my team, and Thabo departs today as a very close and personal brother to me. And that's how the relationship has changed over 20 years. Our relationship was such that we were personal on every matter, and it is for that reason that when Thabo was in the US on a business trip about 3 weeks ago, and we kept myself, him, and Kumbu kept talking, we realized that his wife, Gladys, had just contracted COVID, and Thabo made us aware when he was home, was away from home, and wanted to come back home quickly to be with his wife and support her. Of course, we gave some advices on what to do in the meantime whilst he's traveling. And upon his arrival back home, he really attended and was there for his wife. He himself, a few days later, after the wife went into hospital, confirmed to us that actually he tested positive himself. And the journey began in terms of how to get the two of them really back on their feet. Until I think just 4 days after Thabo told us this, that in a chat group he shared with us his through his picture, a picture of the oximeter for his oxygen reading. He shared it with us, and we felt that he needed to get medical attention immediately. And Kumbu, my friend, who will talk here later, our common friend, rushed to his house to go get him to make sure that he gets the right medical attention at that point in time. And that's how Thabo went to the hospital. Of course, in the hospital in the first week, like many of you who are here, you would have been in touch with Thabo. He engaged all of us, he spoke to us, he kept us abreast in terms of how he's doing. and this continued until on a Sunday when he was called, when he was taken into ICU. Prior to that, Mama wasn't finding him. I wasn't finding him as well. And I called the hospital. He quickly called back to say, no, kisiami. My phones were being charged. But I'll call Mama. And he called Mama Tidi that afternoon. But within 2 hours thereafter, he sends me a note to say, listen, I think they want to take me into ICU. Please call this doctor. He gave me the doctor's name. I called the doctor. He wasn't answering the phone, of course, because there's many patients to look after there. And I quickly drove to the hospital, which is not far from my house. At the hospital, I waited for about 20 minutes for this doctor to come out and meet me. And when he came out, he just said to me, look, I've just put your friend on a ventilator. We need to just make sure that he gets quick help ASAP. And that essentially marked the end of the communication that I had with Thabo, because once he was on a ventilator, we could not communicate as we were doing our WhatsApp. And me and Mama had to now, every day, twice a day or so, be phoning the hospital, checking up on how he's doing. And various nurses were very helpful in giving us the update. They're giving us the update on how he's doing and how Gladys is doing at the same time. And it was on Friday morning, mid-morning, that Mama and I went to the hospital to also spend time with the doctor to give us a very comprehensive clinical appraisal of how Thabo was doing. And the doctor was very worried. He was worried that the additional complication associated with his kidneys was making it very difficult for him to be responsive as quickly as they wanted to the medication. And really, we left the hospital very clear that we are dealing with a very critical situation, but we remained hopeful and prayerful. Of course, it was in that evening itself that I got a call from the hospital, literally about just about 5 hours after we had left the hospital, to say, look, we think we have lost the battle, Thabo, and our hearts really sank. It's never been the same since then. But he was gallant. I mean, there's nothing that Thabo showed to us that suggested that he was feeling defeated, that suggested that he had given up. There was nothing that showed into that. If anything else, we all got a big shock in terms of the severity of his condition relative to his feedback and engagement with us. We honestly thought it's a matter of a few days Thabo will be out of there, because he was not sounding or coming across as as being critical. If anything, I need to state it for the records, if anything, Thabo was more concerned about the health of his wife. You know, from the moment he walked in, he was more concerned about the health of his wife. He discussed with me, how long will it take for my wife to be okay? Will she be able to drive again? He was worried about the chores, the school runs, and everything else. And I kept on saying to him, forget about those things, we'll sort it out. If she can't drive, we'll get a driver. Don't worry about this. If she has to spend another month resting, she'll rest. Just focus on yourself now and recover. And the doctors were saying the same, that, you know, tell your friend to really worry about himself now and be here. We'll sort everything else as it is. But being the person he was very worried about and concerned about the state, the well-being of his wife more than himself. So my friend is no more. His memories will live with us. We'll remain loving him. He'll be a brother for us, a brother to us forever. May his soul rest in peace. Mama Khumutsegang, his kids Bontle, Thabo, and Thabiso, you know, from Gladys family as well. Re tsilisegang bathong le rona re latlhegetswe thata.
Re a leboga ke kopile gore puo ka tsala Red Tshipi Alexandra re a leboga ntate Marokane ka tlhaloso e ntle e feletseng. Ntate tsala, re a leboga.
Dumelang. I first met Thabo in the mid-90s go the University of Cape Town. We didn't know each other from Mafikeng, but, you know, as we all congregated in different groups, you know, we came together as, you know, people who come from Mafikeng to support each other and, you know, to be friends. At the University of Cape Town. Early on in our relationship, we found we had, you know, certain commonalities. We both came from God-fearing households. You know, my late mother, Thabo's mother, you know, were people from the church. We knew each other from church, from Grace Bible Church. You know, and we would sort of build our relationship and share jokes about, you know, church, playing piano in church, and, you know, having an overzealous singer, you know, take over the hymn and leave the pianist behind. Thabo had a keen ear for music. He really loved music. He loved house music. And those who were close to him, we used to call him the Twitter King. You know, he really loved his house music, international, you know, sort of house music is what we called it at the time. He was also a great DJ, wannabe DJ, and, you know, had the best mixes, being known for being the best mixes, or having the best mixes. You know, as I thought deep, it's so hard at a time like this, you know, to get your mind out of, you know, the moment. But I really looked deep to try and find some good times, you know, especially from the university days. And I recall that, you know, as youngsters, as we would go to different campuses, Thabo, myself, I think Tuso, a couple of other friends, we went to a party at the University of Western Cape. And then as we were there, Thabo stepped on, you know, a gentleman's foot by mistake, and, you know, he was always a gentleman. He apologized and said, you know, sorry about that. This gentleman did not, you know, take that well. And as this party came to an end, he waited for us with his friends outside. Obviously, we were a little, you know, scared. This guy was from Joburg. You know, we were just simple people from Mafikeng. And I remember that, you know, as we were there, you know, apologizing, this gentleman then reached for his hip for a gun. And, you know, as he reached for his hip, I just remember apologizing and then looking for Thabo around me. Thabo was nowhere to be seen. I then remembered why his friend John Gwusi, who called him 16V, he used all 16 valves to escape the scene and leave me there apologizing. Knowing that Thabo is a very smart man, I also fled the scene, you know, assuming that he probably saw the gun that I saw too. Luckily, some friends who are also from Joburg were nearby and sorted these people out. And then the search began in the bush for me and Thabo, hiding. I didn't realize I lost my keys. I dropped them on the floor as I was running for the car. So they then took my car to go and look for me and Thabo, hooting in the bush. I remember being too scared to even answer, even as I heard my name, waiting for the car to come closer. Eventually they found me. Eventually we continued to look for Thabo, and he eventually appeared from the bush once he was convinced it was his friend. Thabo, you know, being Thabo and being a debater, we eventually acknowledged that, look, we didn't see a gun. Nobody actually saw it. We thought we saw a gun. But he would always argue and say, you know, I'm a very smart guy. You know, whenever there's a risk, I know to get out of the way. As time went on, you know, I came to learn from Thabo also a couple of things that I just want to leave, and I want to leave particularly with the family, particularly with the children. Thabo was a highly disciplined person. We had fun, but somehow Thabo would pass with the best marks, even with some of us struggling quite a bit. You know, he was highly disciplined. He knew when to have fun. He knew when, you know, to take life seriously. And this served him well in his lifelong journey. Highly disciplined. Thabo also was a very determined person. He knew, you know, that the scholarship that he got, he knew you could have the sense that the efforts behind, you know, that his mother and his father had put in to get him where he needed to be, that he could not waste that opportunity. And he always ensured that he took full advantage. Thabo was also very determined. Things that he didn't know, he would learn. He didn't just rely on university to learn. He learned in life. He learned from people. You know, he learned from friendships. Very determined. Those of you who know him would know he would never be faced or swayed in an argument. Once he's made up his mind, he's made up his mind. Thabo was also very humble, you know, in my view, and many, you know, even yesterday spoke about this. You know, that he's come from Lomanyaning village and had, you know, the greatest success in the corporate world. But he would never show, he would never let his ego step on others. He would never allow his ego to change him, to change the man that he was. Very humble from that perspective. Finally, Thabo was a family man, but also a private family man. I respected that a lot. He would speak about you a lot, the children. He would speak about, you know, his wife, Gladys. But he also kept a good distance and, you know, cocooned and protected his family. I respected him a lot, you know, for that. But he would speak with great pride about, you know, Bundle, the different extramural activities and, you know, results from school, etc. Ladies and gentlemen, Thabo's passing has been, you know, very difficult for me, as, you know, as a lifelong friend, as I would say, but, you know, also I'm sure for many of you here, but I would really just like to leave this message, you know, particularly with the children, about his discipline, about his humility, even in the midst of great personal success, he never allowed himself to change, you know. Mummy is there, your grandmother is there, listen to and learn about your father. There's still the opportunity, you know, to do that. Finally, forgive me. Thabo knew how to choose friends. I saw this particularly as he fell ill and he eventually passed. I would quietly sit as we would, you know, be in the planning committee saying, wow, friends like these are the type I need to have. They really show themselves in the not just in the good times, but in the bad times. And please remember that. Learn how to choose your friends. Robala ka khotso, TK, rest in power. Amen.
Tsala boga. Tsala, o kgile gore gone go bua tsala tota. Yanong ke tsa gore fa re fitile ka ditsala ra go nna le tsala ya bofelo e bong Khumbulu Thuli. Fa re feta ka ene yanong ke tlabe ke solofela gore ba bang yanong ke 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes, ai e be re feditse. Ke a itse gore ditsala ke tshwanetse di tlhoka nnako tota. Ke a leboga tsala Rel Thuli.
So I've been avoiding to speak at the memorial service. I said I would not be able to speak, and I think it's for a number of reasons. One is that I never thought I would be able to to speak about dog, but I suppose I can't avoid it today because Dan said to me I can't keep talking on behalf of friends but also on behalf of our group. The three of us had a group called Abakhwenyana. But I think it's also because Dog's passing has been deeply personal for me. And I may take more than 2 minutes to talk about it. It's been personal for me because I lost my dad when I was about 3 years old. And he was 26 years old, and he left the three of us as siblings. It was my brother, who was 5 years at the time. It was myself, I was three. And my sister, who was about 6 months old. And 52 years later, we've not been able to bury my dad. And I want firstly to say to the Khokho family, this is very hard for you, but God is great in that today you're able to bury your dad and to bury your son. And I know Gladys is gonna watch this one day. At least she will know where her husband is. But it's also because Doc was at some stage my boss, very, very close friend. I only knew him for about 10 years. But the 10 years that I knew him for has been in my, like a lifetime. So it's a combination of things that come to my mind. It's the first time that I'm shedding a tear. My family would be surprised that I'm actually capable of crying. But it is the first time that I'm crying because of Doc. I want to say a few things and I won't be long. The first thing that I do want to say about Thabo is that when I worked for him, people say a lot of things and have said a lot of great things about Thabo. But one thing about Thabo is that I trusted him. Trust was a big thing. I knew when he said, this is what I will do, that he will do exactly that. And for me, that was absolutely great. And in all the discussions that we had with Thabo and Dan, as friends, right, I knew when Thabo said, I'm going to do this, or when Dan says, I'm going to do this, that's what it's going to happen. And people will say a lot of things, great things about Thabo, and I won't talk a lot about his intellect, I won't talk a lot about, you know, his successes, but the one thing I will say is that for some reasons, Dan and I had this discussion. For some reasons, Thabo knew that he was going to leave early. Because Thabo spent a lot of time with his family. When he was not traveling, time comes over the weekend, he says, I'm now with my family. When you call him on a Saturday, when you call him on a Sunday, he will be in that car or he will be at home and he will be with his kids. He will be Thabiso, you'll hear Thabiso in the background. You'll hear Thabo in the background. He will be talking, you know, to Bondless all the time. He loved his family. And the amount of time, I know a lot of fathers who are 60 years old and they've still spent less time than the amount of time Thabo spent with his kids. And I love the way he invested in his family. Because here we are today, the kids are very young, but they've spent a lot of time with their dad, relatively speaking. And I'm very proud of what Thabo did. I do want to say that when he sent Dan and myself his oxygen readings, and Dan calls me on the side and said, Kumbu, I think we must rush this guy to the hospital. We talk on the side and he says, I'm not going to the hospital. We then negotiate with him to say, at least go to your doctor just to confirm that this oxygen reading is okay. I drove to his house. The four of them were there. When I got there, Thabo was perfectly normal. It was a normal dog that I knew. So I said to Mama, because I had just recovered from COVID, I said to Mama, when last did he eat? And Mama says, he has just finished lunch. And I said, what did he eat? Mama says, pap, meat, and veggies. And she says, he actually finished his meal. I said to Mama, he is gonna be fine. In fact, I think there's even something wrong with his oxygen reading. Anyway, he jumps into my car. Take him to the doctor, 2 o'clock appointment. After an hour, I come back. He sends me a message. No, Kumbu, please come back at 4 o'clock because they're not comfortable with my oxygen level, and they're now putting me on a trip. 4 o'clock, he calls me. He sends a message to the group. Says, please come after 5 o'clock. Now, here is a man that I walked into the doctor's room with, right, walking perfectly fine. I come back just after 5. My friend is on a stretcher. He is now sleeping like this, checking his messages, and I can't drive him back home. I now have to drive home to get his bag. And I'm now telling Tabiso say, as I came back, he says, "Daddy, daddy, daddy, daddy." He looked, daddy is not there. As I came down, he says, "Where is my dad?" Anyway, drop off his bag, come back home. What really breaks my heart, which is why I've not been wanting to talk, is that the next time Dan and I drives into dog's house, just after 8 o'clock at night, to tell Mama that we've just received this message from the hospital. Dan drives, I drive behind him. As soon as Mama saw both cars, we never told her what happened. We never told Bontle what happened. She immediately said, "My son is gone." So it's hard. But I want to say to the family, in Psalm 34, verse 18, the Bible says, "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in spirit." And I want you to know, as the Hoko family, that this is the moment when God is close to you and your hearts are broken, but he is there for you as a family. And I know that Gladys will be out very soon. And these kids, Mama, will grow and they will become very, very successful people in the future. May God continue to bless you and may you be strengthened.
Thank you, friend. Ore tlhaloseditse tota re ukile gore o tsala ya nnete. Re a leboga. Bagaetsho, mo nakong ya gompieno ya gone yanong, what we are going to do, ra go kopa ba mo sound mo le mo ba tshameke something, a clip e bontshang gore Thabo o re mo itseng o gompieno a boang gote ke doctor. One adira in the community. Ronare renile le ne ya ka ngwana a gola a go theogela. Ya no a re boneng gore o dirile eng mo community. Thank you very much.
As an employee of Connect Petrol and Refining Company, I am saddened by the news coming from Kadira Holdings that our CEO is dead. Dr. Tabo has been so impactful on our company. And it brings so much sad, and I want to say to the family, take heart and may light perpetual shine upon him and all those who have faithfully departed. Thank you.
As an employee of this company, I felt very broken in the sad news about our former CEO. And I would love to say rest in peace, Dr. Tabo. God bless you. Behind for this institution and Liberia as a whole mission. On behalf of colleagues like Vivian, really, my whole staff of this company, say sorry to the family of Dr. Tabo for his passing. We are in prayer with you, hoping that God Himself will touch your heart so that you will find peace. Once again, we say sorry and may his soul rest in glory.
Be of honest and real,
I'm so sorry on because of Dr. Tabo. We want to say to the family, take heart, stay sorrow in the Lord. And we pray that his soul rest in perfect peace. So for and on behalf of our colleagues team in Liberia, we want to extend our condolences to the family of Dr. Tabo. We pray and hope that we found solace in the Lord. Rest in peace, Dr. Tabo.
Has faded and the candle runs down and the loss of someone can bring us low. When your heart feels heavy and your burden sore, we remember a dear friend that's with us no more. So giving and kind, his compassion will remain.
ke a leboga re ntse re lebeletse ditiro tse dintle tsa ga Dr. Thabo Kgogo kwa a neng a dira teng ko mmerekong wa gagwe. Ke dilo tse dintle, re a leboga. A ke tse nako e go kopa to the stage Reginald Crawford. Thank you, Reginald. And then morao ga gagwe Karabo Kgogo a ipaakanye. Ke a leboga.
Excuse me. It's been for so many people not here today, who most of you probably will never meet and don't know that are there. They miss Dr. Thabo deeply. I came to know Dr. Thabo, your dad, about 8 years ago. We started working together, and I was in this photo with him that you see there. We started working together to build a refinery in Liberia. And it's funny because when we started, I was working for Dr. Thabo, and then your dad's team decided to do something different, and then he came to work with us. And we waited about 10 months, almost a year, for when Dr. Thabo could finally join. And because, you know, you always like two things in a person, in a professional, in a man. Someone who's smart and as clever as Dr. Thabo would always remind us he was. And also someone that you can trust to do the right thing when no one was looking. And that was one of his strongest talents. But I think his greatest talent was that we took on challenges that haven't been taken on the continent in a long time. And your dad was responsible for the lives, well-being, energy security for two countries. Millions of people were dependent on your father. And in the 3 years that we worked together under Dr. Thabo's leadership, we achieved things that have not been done. The president of Angola wishes your father that he rests in peace and wishes you the best. The president of Liberia was dependent upon your father and sends his condolences to the family. The partners of our firm, of which your father was the CEO of our refinery group, are deeply hurt, sad, and in shock. And you should know that in the last 3 years, I've started every day with a discussion with your father and ended every day with a discussion about his children. No matter how busy or what we asked of him, he said, "Reggie, I have to go take my daughter to college." Or around 7 o'clock, he'd say, "Reggie, I have to go speak with my son." We sent him to the U.S. For what we were doing. And his response to me was, when I said, "Okay, you're going back to Angola now," he said, "Nope, I have to go to my wife. And he didn't ask. He told me. And I said, I understand. And that's just who he was. I will forever have a hole in my heart. But time does heal all wounds. God is real. He is very real. And there's nothing that any of us can say to make this better. But in time, it will be better for all of us. So, on behalf of everyone that I represent, Tabiso Tabo Buntley, you can always call me Mama. Please call me son. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Crawford. You know, with a voice like that, we always would like to say Brazil. And it sounds so nice. Yeah, you see, Brazil.
Thank you very much. Rekupa re karabokoho. Khotla go re balela tsa botshelo jwa moswi. Me fa are balela tsa botshelo jwa moswi. I'm going to to ask everybody to stand up on his feet as the technical team will be playing something very nice in the background. Thank you, Ntate Karabo.
Tabot Clifford Koko was born on the 14th of April 1976 in Mafikeng. He is the only child of the late Remagano Christian Koko and Mme Matshidiso Irene Koko. Remagano o tsetswe ke rre wa geng le Mme Matanki Koko. Re wa geng o tsetswe ke Rre Tau le Mme Tempele Kgogo. Mme Matanki o tsetswe ke Rre Thebenyane le Mme Manini Makgwana. Mme Mme Matshidiso a tsalwa ke Rre Moopo le Mme Moroba Ramose. Rre Moopo a tsalwa ke Rre Mamurunyane le Mme Pale Ramose. Rre Mamurunyane a tsalwa ke Rre Makhube le Mme Bobejane Ramose. Mme Mme Moruba a tsalwa ke Rre Zakaria le Mme Setobokwane Motsung. Tabo started his schooling at Lumanyaneng Primary School and proceeded to Boitshoko Middle School. For his Standard 5 class, he was promoted to Standard 7 because of his academic excellence and continued to top his class. With the opening of the international school in Mafikeng, Tabo went for the interviews and successful in being admitted for his Standard 8 class. He completed his A-levels at the international school, having received a number of academic awards that still makes him one of the most decorated people from the School of school to date. Thabo's excellence was recognized when he was presented with an important accolade by the European Council of International Schools Award. For his achievements at the International School of South Africa in Mafikeng in class of 1995, Thabo developed a great friendships from his childhood days and maintained them throughout his life, as evidenced by the testimony of many of various platforms in this past week. Armed with a scholarship, Thabo was accepted at the University of Cape Town to study for Bachelor of Science degree in Chemical Engineering. Upon completion of the degree, he was employed by the De Beers in the Marine Division as a graduate metallurgist in the offshore of alluvial diamond mining operation in the Namibian waters. Upon completion of his graduate metallurgist program in November 2002, Thabo was recruited by Petro SA, the National Oil Company of South Africa, as part of a cohort of young engineers to be introduced to the specialized discipline of petroleum reservoir engineering. After a structured in-house program of 2 years, Thabo was offered a scholarship to pursue a global program leading to a master's petroleum engineering at Imperial College. University of London, he rejoined Petroleum SA upon a completion of his master's program as principal engineering and was part of multiple disciplinary geoscientist teams responsible for petroleum assets, reservoir management and mergers and acquisition teams. Whilst in this role, Thabo proceeded with his studies towards doctorate in petroleum engineering, specializing in the complex analysis of hydrocarbon reservoir pressure analysis for determination of geological structures that substantially improves both the estimation of reserves and the expected drainage behavior when production starts. In this area of specialization, Thabo was supervised by a renowned global authority in this field and was one of the handful to undertake PhD studies in the discipline. He authored or co-authored no less than 4 publications in the Journal of the Society of Petroleum Engineers and defended these papers in international conferences overseas. From 2008, Thabo's hard work, intelligence, and teamwork propelled him towards management roles within the oil industry, rising through the ranks of technical manager, vice president operations, CEO within the Petroleum SA or Petro SA, Sakwell, and Caldera Energy. It is in these roles that his humility and care for others became more visible as he led various teams. He was a great mentor and demonstrated same interest in all his staff members across the various levels. He was a dependable leader, attracted the best professionals who enjoyed working with and for him. He was easygoing and could easily connect. These attributes made his team to be quite energized off and on duty. He was passionate about the development of the continent, and his last mayor focused on refinery infrastructure development in Liberia and Angola with the Gemocorp Group from 2019 was manifestation of this passion. The project represented opportunities for the development and empowerment of people, solving national energy challenges, creating shareholder value. He was hands-on and traveled extensively to see the progress of these projects. Thabo was a loving husband and father to his wife and three children. He was equally dedicated to spending time with the family and did so diligently despite the hectic work program. His children adore him. A true testimony of the affection they experienced in his midst and from a distance whenever he was traveling. He loved his mother dearly. And his mother regarded the relationship to have transcended the mother-son relationship to one of being presumed friends. He cared about his friends that he met throughout his life and made effort to catch up with them. All of them experienced him as genuine, no matter how long a period could have elapsed between the contact session. Thabo loved and was loved all around for the great personality he had. Thabo is survived by his wife, Gladys, his three children, Bontle, Thabo and Thabiso, and his mother, Mama Matshidiso. Robala ka kagiso mokgwatlheng minatlo e se rota.
Leboga ka mo bo tswerere jo ba dileng ka yone rra. In short, we can just say the world was his oyster after reading all these things. Thank you very much. Ba ga itsona go e re tlogetse re tla kopa puo ka mongwe wa bana e bong Bontle Kgogo, and then after that Reberia Katamallo, Kopuon Kabora Koro, by Metuki Re O Hans Koro, Kalebo.
So as all of you said that My dad spent a lot of time with us. Every single weekend. Every single weekend, we'd wake up and we'd drive to buy Thabiso and Thabo food. Even during the week, we did that, and Thabiso would get annoyed because my dad would be on work calls. And he used to say, who are you calling now? And my dad would say, I'm calling Reginald and everyone else. And Thabiso would say, no, Reginald can wait. I want McDonald's. And every moment when my dad wasn't working, he was just with us. And on the Friday that he passed away, I had taken my brothers with my grandmother to cut their hair because I didn't know what to do with their hair. So then my dad was like, okay, you can cut it then before I'm back. And I thought that he'd be back by Monday. So then we went to cut their hair. And every day since then, Thabiso keeps asking, where's daddy? He needs to go and see my hair. And I always told Thabiso that daddy can see your hair. And he loves it very much. And later that night when they came to tell us, they hadn't said that yet that it was my dad who died. So I was just seeing everyone cry and I was just very stressed because my mother's also in hospital. And my dad was our best friend. And when I had heard what had happened, it just felt like a part of me had just left. Like just a part of my soul just had completely disappeared, and I just felt like my whole world just came crashing. I spoke to my dad every single day. And before he went to ICU and they took his phone, he was sending messages because he knows that I stress. My dad and I were exactly the same. We worried too much and he didn't want me to hear his voice at first because he didn't want me to hear that he was sounding sick. But then I said, it's fine. And I called my dad and us three spoke to him. And we said that we love him and that we miss him a lot and we can't wait to see him. Obviously not knowing that that would be the last time that we would hear his voice. And it's very hard to know that next weekend we're not going to wake up and then go with my dad to the shops like we always did. But it gets better. My dad always said that to me. That you're always going to have hard challenges. But eventually it gets better. And I know that my dad loved us dearly. And he loved my mom very much. And I know that my mom's going to watch this. And I know that we'll be strong together. And remind my brothers how good of a dad that we had. Especially Thabiso, because he still doesn't understand. Today he wakes up and he says, are we going to go and see daddy? But it is going to get better. And we're lucky that my dad had such great friends that we can talk to anytime. And yeah.
I want to say, and I can't say anything.
Okay. You want to
mashana say.
It's okay. But thank you for hearing us. And when my brothers watch this, when they're older, so they understand more, I just want them to know that Daddy loved us a lot, and he's watching over us every single minute of the day. Thank you.
Logo ke mo khwatleng ke tlo ye selopo ya rang go ditona re yo tla ke tla di tlhogetsa ka lanoka ba ro tsebe ditona ga se ditsebe ke kobo ya me go nne ke bo bua bontla ka bo khutswane ke fella fo tse dintsi lo dukwile pula.
Ke a leboga re Kgogo mafoko a molemo a makhutshwane a tlhamaletseng ba ga itso ke ntse ke sa bue, but please I'm aware that we are running out of time, but I need to say this. Especially to the fathers. What are your children going to say about you when you are gone? Are they going to say similar words that were said by Bontle? Or my father was our friend? Or whenever my father was not at work, he was with us? Now, I like one very big principle that he implanted mo baneng ba gagwe, are everything will get better by the day. Thank you very much. Ausbonke, you had a wonderful father. Thank you, Mama Chidi, you had a wonderful son. Thank you very much. A ke kope gore re kope re Thami Much jaaka wa go bogogadi go tla go ukwa gore Thabo mo ntlentle o ntse go buiwa ka ene a mme le go bogogadi na ntse jalo na re Thabo Much Thami Much re a leboga mme morago ga gagwe re kopa malo no ra go tshameka a clip ya ga mama go kwa gore a reng ka morwa wa gagwe ke a leboga re match.
Shall we pray? Father God, Ancient of Days, Covenant Keeping God, my Father, we coming to you this morning to remind you of the covenant that you remembered when your children, Father God, were held under slavery and captive conditions. You remember the covenant, Father. Lord Almighty, remember us. The pandemic, Father God, is finishing us. Father, we are hurt, we are traumatized, and we are dying. Lord Almighty, I'm crying out to you this morning. Have mercy, Father. Even Gladys, Father God, who is not here, you, and I believe she doesn't know what happened to her husband, Father. Lord Almighty, have mercy. Give her the grace to come out of that coma and come and be a father. Amen. To those children who is fatherless. Her children, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Let me take this opportunity to thank our MC, and to thank the Kgogo family.
and the March family and all the pastors who are here, fellow mourners. It is indeed with a heavy heart that I'm standing here. Can I remove it, MC? It is indeed with a very heavy heart that I'm standing here this morning. I am traumatized by the loss of my son-in-law. I'm standing here representing my brother, Father Tabo's father-in-law, who passed away in 2016, during which time I worked closely with Tabo during the funeral arrangements of my brother. But one thing stood out as far as Tabo is concerned. I was struck by the humility this man portrayed. Tabo was a very humble man. And Tabo was not this "do you know who I am" type of person. Now it came to me, it was evident to me why Tabo was so successful academically. It's because of his humility. You see, humility is a word that is divine. Something divine attracts positiveness, and it produces positive results. That is why Tabo was so successful climbing the corporate world, because of his positive attitude, which was humility. Tabo was a father. I would like to define the father that Tabo was in the following manner. The F would stand for a founder, foundation, and the A, an all-rounder. The T would stand for a teacher. The H, Tabo was a head, and Tabo was an executor, and Tabo was a researcher, a complete man. What else do we expect? That is why today, when I sat there, one word stood out. Somebody mentioned that Tabo was a very humble man. And indeed, I can attest to that. We have lost a son-in-law, and Tabo was a family man. Tabo ufile ngwana rona bophelo bo e leng gore ba le bantsi ba rona we can only dream about. So we feel the loss as the March family and as the Kuhu family. But to Tabo's mom, "Mama, nte ke go re kere ke tswa ko botlhoko bo ke a boitse ke bo experience tse makgethonyana." Me motho o bongwe fela o tla go fodisang, "Mama, nte ke re ga ise motho, ke Modimo wa rona o ko le godimo o tla go comforta, o tshepe yena. Rona re le batho ga re kgone, go na le fo re felelang teng, mare Modimo ga a felelwe, Mama, o tla go comforta." And to the children of Tabo, to you, my daughter, hold on to him, our father. And I personally will continue to intercede for your mother, to ask God to have mercy and let us come back and be a father to you, because your father is no more. she's got two roles to play now. But at the end of the day, God will see her through. Bagaitso, ke na le ma go dilo tse dintsi tse nka di buang ka Thabo. Ka ntateng ya nako, e re eme ka fo phefo re mo radisi. Ke ska ka ya lolo lolo. Moho Thabo, I would want like to say to you, Thabo, thank you for being my son-in-law. And thank you for this humble man that you were. But akuhlanga lungehlanga. Good night, Thabo.
There are no words to describe how my heart is broken by your sudden departure to glory. When I came to your place to help taking care of the kids because their mommy was in hospital, we had such a quality time together to catch up until you started being sick and admitted in hospital. I never thought that I was seeing you for the last time after spending time together for 5 days. When you and your wife, ladies, were both in ICU, I was alone with the kids and I felt overwhelmed. I called a close friend, a family friend, Martha and my sister, Pomoto, to come help me with the kids and to pray for you. Their presence made a huge impact because as a mother, I was emotionally traumatized. 2 days before your departure, I and Martha had an overwhelming and tangible encounter with God's presence. And the spirit of heaviness left and we felt peace. We never gave up and never stopped believing God for a miracle, irrespective of what the doctors said about your progress until your departure. I realized that God was preparing me for what was coming. I'm heartbroken, but God gave me the supernatural strength during this time of loss. I thank God for blessing me with such a precious gift, Thabo, for 45 years. I was not only a mother to you, we were best friends. We loved together and had a strong bond. You are such a phenomenal, amazing, and incredible person who was generous, loving, caring, and respecting all people. It was a privilege and honor to be your mother. The measure of life is not its duration, but in its donation, and nothing can fill the gap of your loss. And you will be dearly missed. Thabo, you are gone too soon, but you will never be forgotten. Goodbye. Till we meet again, may your precious soul rest in eternal peace.
Mama. Ware, it has been a privilege for me to have a son like you. Thank you very much. Magaitso, re ya go se buin sa bofelo re Michael Diteko Ramose. Re a leboga re Michael Diteko Ramose. Re leboga le ntate Mach. Really, you had a good relationship with your son-in-law. Thank you very much.
Ke le dumedisa lotlhe Phuthego le Balesika. I'd like to thank everybody who supported our family since we've been the pastors of prayers. We, as a family, we are still shocked because that passing of Thabo, it came as a surprise to us. And because I hear that Thabo was a great leader, not to his workers, but also to the family. He's a great loss to our family because I thought he's the one who will bury, because he's the only son. His father passed away and he was having only a mother. And I thought
he will marry her mother, but now it's not good at all for her mother to bury. To bury him, because he was a great leader to our family also. When we have the occasion like that, even if he's at overseas, when I phone him that we have a problem like this, he used to assist us even when it's overseas, so that we can and continue the work like this. But now, if it's not around like that, it's going to be difficult to us. And I'm still begging even to the families that, you know, even when Thabo is not there, both families must work to each other and take care of the children, because I was still worried about the recovery of their, for his wife, because the children are still small. So I'm begging you for your prayers that you must pray for his wife so that she can recover and raise the children. I want to call the children and Thabo was a responsible person and never received any complaint from her mother-in-law about his behavior since he married. He was also, every time, I never received any complaint about him. He was married to Gladys, and she got two children, Bontle, Thabo and Thabiso. Yeah. So I'm begging that those both family of Khokho and March must work together and raise those children. So it must not be like the end of the day that we met today. We must still keep on taking care of those children, because we can see those children are still small. They need support of both of you families. I thank you.
Re a leboga malome re ukwile ba ga etse mona go nya gompieno ya gona ano yana a ke kope gona le diana tse di tabogang fa gona le mongwe yo tshwereng sengwe a ka ntsha sa se tshwereng diana dipedi di a taboga ke nako e re tshwannang ke go isa ka go moruti gonne re ukwile gore batho ba reng jaanong ke nako ya go itse gore moruti ka re ukwile gore rona re le batho ra reng modimo ene a reng ke a leboga moruti.
Father, we thank you for the offering. The Bible says, blessed is the hand that gives than the hand that receives. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you. Amen. We may take our seats. Let me take this opportunity to greet OutCD, the Khokho's family, the March family, the friends to Dr. Thabo Clifford Khokho, colleagues, the neighbors, and everybody who knew Thabo, the congregation at large. Let me greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. I believe a lot has been said, Bratabo. I decide not to repeat what has been said. Also giving the fact that the time is not on our favor. We continue to pray for God's divine strength, divine comfort, and healing upon the family of Dr. Thabo,
the children, and then most importantly, ladies, to recover soon. It is the desire of our hearts. We will continue to trust God. The passing of Thabo will never discourage us to continue trusting that God can do a miracle in the life of ladies. I will ask you that we put our faith together. The Bible says, when two or three are together in his name, there he is in the midst of them. We are more than two, we are more than three. So let's continue to say, God, you are great. Also, let me acknowledge the servants of God who are in the house. My wife, Pastor Grace, Deacon Osmarine, other servants of God, Reverend, the priest, the other leaders from different churches and different organizations. Let me also greet you in the wonderful name of my Lord and my Savior Jesus Christ. You know, our city, you know, I remember a scripture in Luke chapter 22, verse 32. The Bible says Jesus Christ was speaking to Peter based on what Peter was experiencing. And Jesus said, Satan wanted to sift you as a wheat. And Jesus said, I prayed for you. We are praying for you, Ma, that your faith should not fail. We are praying for Ma's family that their faith also should not fail. We are praying for Thabo's friends that they should continue to trust God. We pray that, Ocidi, the way you brought up Thabo, God should continue to give you strength, Ma, to raise up Banaba Hawe while waiting for the wife to be discharged. Together with the Mas family, you know, we listen to what people said about Thabo. We watch what he did in the society that tell us how you brought him up. You know, it's a volume on what you did to your son, God giving you strength and grace. I'm going to be brief. I'll just to read two scriptures from two different letters. I'm going to start first reading from 1 Samuel chapter 14. In the Old Testament, I'll read verse 14, and then also I will read Ecclesiastes, also in the Old Testament, chapter 7. I will read verse 2 of it. It reads 2 Samuel 14:14. It says, for we will surely die and become like water spilled on the ground, which cannot be gathered up again. Yet God does not take away a life, but he devises means so that he banished ones are not expelled from him. Ecclesiastes 7:2. Better to go to the house of the mourning than to go to the house of feasting. For that is the end of all men, and the living will take it to heart. There are many occasions of life that draw us people together, but none affect us more than coming together in the house of the mourning to share our tears. We are here to allow God to use us to comfort the bereaved family. It is our prayer and our wish that they should find solace in knowing that God will never leave them nor forsake them. Our purpose this day is not to determine the fate of our loved one departed, but to remember what he was to each of us. We have read what he did as we were reading his obituary. Friends, colleagues, they told us how they've been relating with him. We want to remember him and the treasured times we drew from him in his love, in his strength, and encouragement. In this grief, we turn to the only place that we can find genuine comfort, our God. We don't understand the pain that our CD is experiencing. We don't understand the pain that the March family they are experiencing, that the children to Dr. Tambo are experiencing. But the Almighty God, the creator of everything, he does understand what they are experiencing. The Bible says, for we will surely die and become like water spilled on the ground. Friends, relatives, neighbors, let us learn something from the passing away of Bratabo. Let his funeral remind us that we will surely die. It's not a matter of maybe. The Bible says, for we will surely die and become like water spilled on the ground. No wonder the Bible says, for that is the end of all men, and the living will take it to heart. It does not say the dead. Bratabo lived his life well. He was a gentleman. We have all learned a lot from him. While we are still alive, he has encouraged us. He has told us that as men, we must love our wives. We must build a relationship, a meaning relationship with our children. He cannot come back and relive his life. But me and you, we still have opportunity. We still have the time to make right where we have made wrong. Why? Our time will come, and we, the living, we must take heart, or we must take heed to what the Bible says. Now, having said this, I'm about to close. There is a need for us to prepare for our passing away. Preparation for death is necessary. Why? Because for we will surely die and become like water spilled on the ground. I'm going to talk about few things quickly, four things, on how to prepare myself for death. Because at the funeral of our dear brother, we are reminded that surely we will die. But before I give you four things, let me give you a quote by George Waterfield. George Waterfield says, "Go above and beyond for yourself. You do it for the family. You do it for the friends. You do it for colleagues. But don't forget about yourself. It is important to include yourself." In fact, it's Stephen Lahart, close quote. This person says, we need to go above and beyond for ourselves. It's not wrong. Loving my family is not wrong. In fact, God demanded I must do that. Friends, relating with the friends, relating with the colleagues is not wrong. But he says, don't forget about you. Sometimes we do this, reverite balarona, to prepare ourselves for death. That's Stephen Lahart. And then George Waterfield says, I quote, take care of your life and the Lord will take care of your death, close quote. Very important. As much as I prepare myself for my passing away, as long as I take care of my spiritual being, the Almighty God will take care of my death. Preparation for death is number one. What to do quickly, and we'll be going. Can I ask somebody to alert me when the hearse arrives, please? Yes. Yes, my brother, you alert me. Bless you. What to do to prepare myself for death? Number one, we need to know always and to remember that we are strangers in the foreign land. We are not supposed to live as if we are here forever. When I remember that I am a sojourner, I am a pilgrim here, then I will prepare myself, knowing that I am in transit. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 5, chapter 2, verse 11, it says, beloved, I beg you as sojourners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts which war against the soul. Number two, what to do to prepare myself for death? Remember, we will all die, including the preacher, God forbid, for now. Number two, we must use this life to prepare for another world. While we are still here, because beyond this world, beyond where we are now, there is no preparation. We use the life we are in now to prepare for another world. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 says, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Seek first the kingdom of God. As we accumulate things, it's not wrong to accumulate things, but during our accumulation process, we must seek first the kingdom of God. We must remember that I am a sojourner here on earth. I must remember that I am in transit. Number three, our death will be precious in God's sight. provided we prepared ourselves. Our death, remember, we said earlier on, when we take care of ourselves, the Almighty God will take care of our death. Psalms 116, verse 15, it says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. We may be crying today, but my Bible tells me that precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of a person who prepare for his soul, who prepare for her soul. I'm saying to us, our death will be precious in the sight of the Almighty if ever we took time to prepare ourselves. Lastly, we need to know that there isn't many ways to go to God. For John chapter 16, the last scripture, verse 6, it says, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus is the only way. There isn't many ways to God. For my life or my death to be precious before the Almighty God, I need to know that Jesus is the way to eternal life. Jesus is the way to God, not the church, not the pastor, not the prophet, but Jesus himself. He said, unless I am born again, I cannot enter the kingdom of God. At the funeral of our dear brother, let there be a preparation. Let's all know that Jesus is the way, the truth, and life. Without him, we cannot make it to God Almighty. May God comfort the family. May God strengthen the children. May God's hand be upon them. He's not a man that he should lie, neither a son of man that he will change. We pray that Gladys must recover soon. We pray that God should do miracle in the life of Gladys. Let us pray. Father, we pray right now for Gladys, Lord. There is no distance in prayer. Wherever Gladys is in the hospital, Father, we pray that the angels should surround her. We pray for speedy recovery. Oh, my Lord, you will never let us down. The great I am, we continue to trust. We pray for Gladys and Tabo's children. We pray for the Kohos family. We pray, Lord, for the Marsh family. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, even as we'll be going to the graveyard, we pray, Lord, that you lead us by your spirit, that your will be done, not the will of the devil. To you be the glory, to you be the honor, forever and ever, dear Lord, we pray, and the church say amen. Thank you very much. What we'll do now, we'll just allow them to open for a few minutes, and then from there, then we'll be going to the graveyard. God bless you. We have prayed already. We'll just proceed to the graveyard. I'm going to ask the gentleman to give us a wonderful piece of song as we go. Bless you. We still ask for your comfort, for your mercy, my God, and your grace upon us, upon the family, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. My Lord and my King, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us forever, we pray. Amen.
Yeah. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like seas billows roll,
shall return.
Amen.
As human being, we are in three parts. You are a spirit, you have a mind or a soul, and you live in the body.
Amen.
What we are going to lay down here is not the real Thabo. The real Dr. Thabo left some few days ago, which is his spirit.
Amen.
We are going to bury or lay down in the grave the body where once Dr. Thabo lived.
Amen.
And the word says, we must remember, all of us, that we are dust, and that the dust will return. And the spirit, the real you, me, the real Dr. Cliff, will go back to the place it prepared while still alive.
Amen.
We continue to pray that the family, the children, colleagues, friends, be comforted, that they should find solace in knowing and understanding that God loves them.
Amen.
With these few words, we are going to ask gentlemen to help us to cover the body where once Dr. Cliff lived. As we do that, we'll continue to sing, may the good Lord comfort the family.
Hallelujah.
Let's come, gentlemen.
Oh, hallelujah, Rena. Limu emedi di moya. Oh, hallelujah, moya. Oh, hallelujah, moya. Oh, hallelujah, moya. Oh, hallelujah. halalela rena le moye medi moya o halalela rena le moye medi moya o halalela 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 rena le moye medi moya o halalela rena le moye medi moya o halalela
o ntse o ipelaela gore o ka re ga o itse go opela ikgomotse ka gore go opela nna gompieno yaanong itatlhele re a leboga a re ye ka nngwe gape ausego ga ise batlhagelele ke tla go bolelela fa batlhagelele. Oh, ke bao, ke bao. Mama we wa itse kantele no opela monate bo bo belaela gore maybe ga opele sene ya no ke a go nete faletsa a ye mo seralo
Jesus, oh, my God, Hallelujah. sentle tota a ke re mona go nya go mpieno ke kope ka boikokobetso re o Hans Kogo gore a tla gore lebogela and then ke lebelele mo councilora ke dumela gore o teng ka gore ba taboga masotlhe a se gantsi o nna sure gore o teng le ene a ipaakanye mo councilora and then wa bofelo ya go nna puo ka borra mosiane fa kgosi e le gore o teng re a mo amogela re ikokobetsa mo pele ga gagwe mme fa e le gore ga yo ke a itse gore go na le moemedi wa gagwe re oupa mosiane gore a ka moemelela ka jalo ka kokobetsa wa gaetso ka boikokobetso re kgogo o kae o re kgogo dase
My pastor, I want to thank you, sir, for the service that you have rendered to make sure that the path of TK is well. Thank you. Program director, I also want to thank you for ensuring that the program goes well, although there were some changes, but you manage it. I also want to thank the greatest man. It's not every man who does this. That's why I'm saying they are the greatest. Who built this house for Tabo? We want to thank you guys. Thank you again. One more time, I want to thank Tabo's friends, Dan and friends, CP and friends, and all the other friends that I've been mentioned. We thank you for your support, guys. Your diligence has indeed consoled the entire family. I also want to thank the community of Lumayane, Musiani View, for the support that you have given us today. When you heard that we had set moment at Kogo's family, you came and support us. We really want to thank you. Thanks everyone for your hands, for everything that we have done today. It's when you get back home, the food will already have been dished out. So when you get home, because of the condition that we are living on, just get your food and make sure that those who goes back safe. Those who stays behind to give us more comfort, you are still welcome. Thank you for your back. Ke a leboga Rekgogo. Rekgogo o kgona go leboga tota. O ba cover. Ga gona ope o tsholetsang letsogo a re ga o mo leboga. Ke a leboga rra gore ba lebogile botlhe. Mme ke lebogile gore go na le ntlha e tona e o sa e lebalang. Batho ba kgopisa ka mo go maswe fa o ka e lebala. Fa o ka lebala go bua gore go na le sengwe go gae. Jaanong o se buile o ba itumedisitse tota. Ke a leboga. Ke buile gore a mokhanselara o teng. O ko phitlhong e nngwe o siame. Mme ke tla kopa kgosi ya rona Chief Kgosi Chris Mosiane fa e le gore o teng, mme fa seo ke a itse gore re oupa Mosiane wa ba ntse le teng go mo rwalela ditlhako. Mme a ke re bagaetso, pele fa kgosi a bua, ke re ke lebogile tota gore le be le nkapesitse uniform-o ya bo traffic officer. Traffic officer a nka tshwenyega gore koloi kanakang. Fa e tla o kgona gore ka gore o apere uniform o tsena mo tseleng koloi nngwe le nngwe go sa kgathaletse ka size ya ema. Jaanong ke lebogile tota gore le mphile tlotlo eo. Ga ke riana jaanong ke a apola uniform e ke a go tshwana le mongwe le mongwe jaanong. Ke a leboga kgosi.
Ya mo boemong wa Ramosiane re khosi Mosiane Chris ga teng mme o ne a salantse a buile mo laborarong ga nne a etsa go communicator a ba re ne oupa o teng ka ko a tla le bontshe mo re tlabang lerapo la moisimonyana wa rona teng. Selo se segolo se nka se etsang ga nne go kgonagala ke letlega ke ne ke tla saluta monnao ke re tsamaya morokgogo o tsamaye o robale morokgogo o robale jaaka lesea mme tota ke Setswana fela se nang robala morokgogo rekgogo Victor o lebogile go tlala seatla se segolo se nka se buang fela ke gore a lerapo la morolong le seka la gogwa ke marapo ke utlwile o leboga ditsala dingwe wa nkutlwisa botlhoko nkgopotsa selo sengwe se tlhaga mo bukeng e ntsho e Dafita o raya Jonathan a re tsala yaka o mphelegetse le ka tsatsi la mela le bitlha ke bona banna ba thote matsapa go tla mo feleletse mme ne ka re morwakgogo a ka re tlogelela ga ke re pula ga re tle gore pula ra ra ena ke re pula
amen
pula barolo
amen
ra leboga khosi ra leboga bagaetso ga re tsare mohaure re boele kwa ga let's all share the grace of God. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you all.
Amen.